You just heard new music from David Guetta, Sebastian Ingrosso, and Dirty South. And our first guest hails all the way from London, Annie Mack. How you doing?
Hello, Joe. I'm really good. I'm actually slightly delirious, but I'm excited.
Now, how has the US tour been treating you?
It's been cool. I've never actually been on a proper tour like this before, where you're literally getting on a plane every day to a different city and getting very little sleep, an unhealthy amount of sleep. But it's been amazing just to be able to travel around America and Canada and realize that there's a lot of people out there who are aware of what I do and who listen to my show. It's been nice.
Well, checking out your Twitter, you have this great picture of you at In-N-Out Burger, and you look like a kid on Christmas with this hamburger.
Basically, the guy who picked us up from LA told us about In-N-Out Burger, and I've got loads of people back in the UK who always say whenever I come to LA, you've got to have an In-N-Out Burger. So we made it our mission that day. And the guy who brought us there used to work there, so he was able to tell us all the secrets. And it was an amazing meal. Do you know what? I tweeted that picture and then I got a message from In-N-Out Burger saying, great to have you.
That is pretty impressive.
My day, yeah.
So did you try like the Flying Dutchman or any of the like the special burgers?
No, I went straight normal. I went cheeseburger with onions and fries and a strawberry milkshake and it was fine.
It is pretty yummy.
It's amazing, yeah.
So tell me how you got into BBC, because I mean, you are like the focal point now for the dance scene, it seems.
It was kind of a long and quite boring journey, to be honest with you. I did a degree, and then I did like a postgraduate in radio, and then I moved to London and worked in little stations. Eventually got a job at BBC London, just making tea and helping out when people were away, and then eventually got a job at Radio 1 behind the scenes. And I worked behind the scenes for 2 years as an assistant producer on the kind of evening indie show with Zane Lowe, and then due to luck and timing managed to get my own show. So I was very lucky, and since then it's just gone strength to strength, and Radio 1 have been really supportive and kind of embraced me as a presenter and pushed me forward, and I've been happy to be pushed.
Now recently you swapped spots with Pete Tong.
Yeah.
And now you officially kick off the weekend. Is there anything different about the show now, or?
No, we really wanted to keep the show very much the same as it was. I mean, it's done quite well up to now because of it is what it is. The show as an ethos is just a very happy, chaotic show. The first half an hour, maybe play tunes that are slightly bigger, like more mainstream, but not that much. Like, we'll still play all the dubstep stuff and all the drum and bass stuff, and the show's still very much is what it is, yeah.
That's one of the things I love about your show. It's very refreshing musically. You're doing a great job.
Thank you very much. So it's my favorite part of the week is programming those 2 hours, and I'm just really glad that other people like what I like. Thank God.
So one of the signature things you do on the show is the whoop whoop. Where did that come from?
My friend Becky used to say it quite a lot, and my dad actually says it sometimes as well, and I started saying it like in texts and stuff, and then it just became something I said. It was like, well, let me give you a whoop whoop text in, and then we got it printed on t-shirts, and now it's everywhere.
It fits, so big shout out to Becky.
Big shout out to Becky Walker, yeah, proper.
Well, let's check out a song. I know you're big in dubstep and drum and bass. Do you have a favorite right now?
Something I suppose that's been doing the rounds all summer and has been like my biggest track in terms of dubstep at all the festivals has been Deadmau5 and Cascade, I remember, but it's a Casper remix, just kind of what I call Balearic dubstep. It's kind of very, it's not grimy, it's kind of soft on the ears and very accessible and nice.
Well, it has that edge, but it has that nice music element to it.
Yeah, it's not gnarly, it's melodic, it's nice. So yeah, this is big for me.
All right, let's check it out right now.
Cool.
Remember how you pulled me through. MassMovementRadio.com.